ओ गदाधर।
हरे कृष्ण मदर सची, I cooked Nimai's favorite kheer and brought it for him.
Nimai is not home yet. He went out to bathe at the banks of Ganga in the morning, but has not still returned. Even though it's already sunset, I am worried about him. Can you go and search for him and tell him to return home as soon as you find him?
Of course, Mother Sachi. I will go and search for him immediately. Do not worry. I'm sure Nimai is just playing and has lost track of time. I will bring him back home safely.
Gadai, please always be with Nimai. Only you can control him. He is very naughty, you know. He steals things from others, beats other children, and enters their house to steal their food. Even though there is nothing he lacks here in his own house, only by your gentle influence is he controlled. Otherwise, he always finds a way to get himself into trouble. Please, promise me, Gadai, that you will always be with him.
Yes, Mother. I promise I will always be with Nimai and protect him.
Meanwhile, at the banks of Ganga.
What do we have here today? Beautiful gardens. Oh, and this wonderful. Smells so nice. And what's over there?
Nimai, why did you take our garland and sandalwood?
We were using it for worship of Lord Shiva.
Why are you disturbing us, Nimai?
Don't worry, my dear sisters. I have come to give you a benediction. My benediction for you today is that... You will all get very handsome husbands. Now, offer me the sweets too that you brought.
No, Nimai.
The sweets are not for you.
If you do not give me the sweets, then I will curse you. Every one of you will have an old husband. And at least 4 co-wives for each of you.
Okay, Nimai. Take this sandesh.
And these are lettuce.
And you?
These are the jalebis for you.
Very nice.
Did you study for the exam tomorrow? We should study the notes again. I hope that there will only be easy questions.
You boys, where do you study?
We study at Pandit Ganga Prasad's Gurukul.
Oh, very good. What does he teach you?
He teaches us Nyaya philosophy.
Nyaya philosophy, conceived by Akshapada Gautama 2000 years ago. So tell me, what did you learn today?
Today we learned that our consciousness is about perception of external reality.
But how could consciousness be about perception? Perception is subjective, influenced by your state of mind. But consciousness is the same for us all, isn't it?
Yes.
Now go! Tell your teacher that his philosophy is useless.
In contrast to Nimai's fiery nature, Gadadhar was composed, not at all interested in speculative argumentation. He was immersed in love of Krishna and always prayed for his friend Nimai to become a devotee.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Gadai, come here. What are you doing? Always chanting on beads all day. Look how much fun is it to argue with Gurukul students on the basis of scriptures. Tell me, what is consciousness according to Naya philosophy?
Nimai, when will you understand the power of Krishna's holy names? You are licking the jar of honey on the outside, but when will you open the jar and dip your fingers to taste this honey yourself?
Following the prayers of his dearmost friend Gadadhar, Nimai soon became a devotee and accepted initiation from Sripad Ishwarapuri. After spending years as a devotee in Navadvip, he finally took sannyas and moved to Puri, the home of Lord Jagannath. Gadadhar Pandit, being like a shadow of Lord Chaitanya, followed him and himself accepted Kshetra Sannyas in Puri, taking a vow to never leave the city and always be in association of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Gadai!
Gauranga!
Gadai!
Gauranga! I have been waiting for you. Look, I prepared your favorite kheer for you.
Ah, Gadai. Kheer made by your hands has always been my favorite. Gadai, your reading of the Srimad Bhagavatam is most nectarian. Shall we read a story together?
Yes, let's read the story of Narasimha Dev and Prahlad Maharaj. Once upon a time, there was a great devotee of Lord Vishnu, Prahlad, who was the son of the great demon king Hiranyakashipu. Prahlad was a saintly personality, but his father Hiranyakashipu was furious at his devotion and ordered his soldiers to kill his own son. He ordered his soldiers to throw Prahlad off a mountain, but Prahlad was caught gently by a soft bed of flowers as Vishnu protected him. Then he commanded that Prahlad be placed in a pit of poisonous snakes. However, snakes slithered around Prahlad without harming him as Vishnu protected him. Then he ordered a herd of wild elephants to trample Prahlad, but the elephants refused to harm him as Vishnu protected him. Then he attempted to burn Prahlad alive by placing him in a pot of boiling oil. Yet the oil turned cool and harmless as Vishnu protected him. Hiranyakashipu then asked Prahlad, "Where is Lord Vishnu?" Prahlad told him, "He is everywhere, even in the pillar in front of him." Shattering the pillar, the Lord then appeared as a half-man, half-lion, placed Hiranyakashipu on his lap, tore open his stomach, and protected his devotee Prahlad.
Where is my Lord Gadai? Where has he gone? Why has he left me alone in this world? Why am I still alive without him, Gadai? Why? Where is my Shyam Sundar with the complexion of a fresh rain cloud, a peacock feather on his head, wearing pitambar clothes, holding his flute to his lips? Where is he, Gadai?
He has not gone anywhere, Gauranga. He is here, always with you in your heart. So what reason is there to lament?
May Gopinath, who attracts all the gopis with the song of his flute and who dances the sweetest rasa dance in Vamsivat on the banks of Yamuna, be merciful upon us. Shriman Ras Rasarambhi Vamsi Vat Tatastitha Karshan Venu Svaner Gopir Gopinath Shriyestuna.
Gadai!
He is coming. Do you sense it? He is coming.
Gauranga, don't do something crazy. Last time you jumped into the sea, thinking it to be the Yamuna.
Gadai, it is now your responsibility to serve Gopinath with all your heart.
The most beautiful form of Gopinath from the garden, manifested by the hands of Gauranga, Sri Tota Gopinath. Tota Gopinath has arrived. My Prabhu has arrived. Prabhu eshe gachen. Amar Prabhu eshe gachen. By the mercy of Gauranga, Tota Gopinath!
Gadadhar? Gadai.
Nityananda Prabhu.
Gadai.
Nityananda Prabhu.
Gadai. I heard the good news that Sri Tota Gopinath has been manifest by Gauranga, and I could not stay away. Look what I have got, a beautiful set of clothes for Gopinath. And here is a special rice for him. I know it is his favorite.
Nityananda Prabhu, please make yourself comfortable. I prepare the bhoga right away. Nityananda Prabhu, how can I serve only rice to you? I don't have anything to serve with it. Ah, a tamarind tree. I'll take some leaves and I have some green chilies. I'll make some saag and chutney to serve with this rice.
Ah, smells delicious. Now I see why Gauranga loves you so much.
Am I the only one who's not invited to this party? What is this delicious smell that attracted me all the way from my cottage in Gambira?
Gauranga!
Gadai! Nitai! Where is my prasad? There is nothing in this world like your cooking, Gadai.
Can I have some more?
But there is only one portion remaining. That's mine.
No, that's mine.
It's mine.
No, it's mine.
Look over there.
Ha 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 ha
I have completed my mission on this planet of spreading love of Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is non-different from His holy names. If one chants the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, he will certainly awaken his dormant love for Krishna's lotus feet. To spread this Maha Mantra, I have started the Sankirtan movement that will now grow throughout the whole world by the efforts of my devotees. In every town and village, the chanting of my name will be heard. O my Lord, now be causelessly merciful to me by giving me a place with the particles of dust at your lotus feet.
And thus, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu disappeared from this world by entering the deity of Sri Tota Gopinath through his knee.
Gauranga! 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 Where have you gone? Where are you, Gauranga? Gauranga!
After the disappearance of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, experiencing intense separation, Sri Gadadhar Pandit's body turned frail and weak, and his back stooped. Due to this, he was not able to offer garlands to the deity of Sri Tota Gopinath.
My dear Gadadhar, due to your weak physical condition, you are not able to put garlands around my neck any longer. However, I cherish receiving this service only from your hands. I will now make myself seated so that you can continue offering your garlands to me.
And thus, Sri Tota Gopinath became the only sitting deity of Lord Krishna. O most merciful Gopinath, I bow down to your lotus feet and serve you eternally. Gopinath, Krishna, Jagannath, Gauranga, Gaurahari, Gaurahari, Gaurahari.
Panchatattva broke the lock of the storehouse of love of God. They drank it, plundered it, and it is said, and the stock of this storehouse was never depleted. Never. He said, the more you distribute, you find the more there is. This is the secret. The more you distribute the holy name and you give everything away, if you give away all the mercy that you received, then you find that you have more than before. That is why on this day of Gaur Purnima, we must go on Harinam. We must. No excuses. Because by distributing this holy name, we will wind up with more than we had before. And then we share that also. And then still more, and still more. And before we know it, we are jumping up and down, uncontrolled, in ecstasy.